Today we will learn how to configure dynamic NAT. In this topology, the IP addresses are pre-configured. There is a host and an internet which is connected through router 4. And on router 4 we have to implement dynamic NAT. So dynamic NAT means that we have a pool of addresses taken that we will use to provide real IP addresses to a group of users on the inside. Now moving to the configuration of dynamic NAT, first move to the conf mode, then interface 00/0 IPNAT inside. The IPNAT inside command identifies that interface as an inside interface. Now interface 00/1 IPNAT outside. The IPNAT outside command identifies as the output interface, and then exit. Now we have to create an access list. 1. Permit 12.0.0.0.0.0.0.255 and enter. Now we have to create a pool. So IPNAT inside source list and the access list number 1 and pool, and then I have to give my name to the pool, so we will give Cisco and enter, and then IPNAT pool. And then the name of the pool, Cisco, and then 196.15.60.100, and then we have to create a pool, so we will create pool of 10 IPs till .110, so 196.15.60.110, and then the subnet mask 255.255.255.0. and enter. So now our dynamic NAT is configured on router 4. We have to also create a static route on internet, since it is not having the information of 196.15.60 network. So IP route 196.15.60.0.255.255.255.0 and serial interface 0/0 and exit. So we have also configured a static route on internet. Now we have to also create a default route on host. So moving to configuration mode, IP route 0.0.0.0.0.0.0 and the next hop 12.0.0.2 and exit. So if I ping my internet from host, so I will get a reply. So we are getting reply if we are doing ping from host to router. If you also want to see that how our NAT is translating the IP addresses, so we can use a debug command, debug IPNAT on router 4, debug IPNAT. Now debugging is on, so first we have to ping host to router and we get our translated IPs. That how NAT is working. Now we can see that when host is sending reply to the internet, when host is sending request to the internet, it is using a source 99.99.99.5, and in the destination it's taking and destination is taking 192.6.15.60.100, and then NAT is translating it to the host, that is 12.0.0.1. So this is how we are getting reply from internet to host. And now if we see that how host is sending request to the internet, so it is taking in source 12.0.0.1, then NAT is translating it to 196.15.60.100, and the destination is 99.99.99.5. So it has dynamically taken the IP from the pool. So this is how we configure NAT, and NAT works, and the dynamic NAT configurations. Thank you.